Let's talk keto, the ketogenic diet. Probably the diet I get asked more about than any other, and maybe that's just because it's the most popular right now. So I'll start off by saying I've done keto. I did it 20 years ago when it was called Atkins. You see, any of these diets are usually something that's been done before, was really popular for a while, and then fell off. And then 10, 15, 20 years later, gets revived, gets named something else, gets spun in a different way, and more people try it. So that's just, I think, indicative of the diet industry in general. People are always looking for that quick fix, that simple magic thing they can do that's gonna work. But if that existed, we'd all be doing it. Like if there was one clear diet that worked for the majority of people for the majority of time, that's what we'd be doing. We wouldn't be onto keto and then intermittent fasting and paleo and whatever the next thing will be. So to talk about keto specifically though, ketogenesis is basically where you're starving your body of carbohydrates intentionally and just eating protein and fat to try to get your body to switch over the energy it burns to primarily fats and ketones, which is this byproduct when you're starving yourself of carbohydrates. I won't go into all the science of it. I won't go into all the medical debate around what's really happening there. I'll just say that for a lot of people, keto works very well short-term, not well long-term. And that's, there are exceptions to that. There are some people who does work short-term and long-term, but for the majority of people, the reason why it works short-term is because when you starve your body of carbohydrates, you drop a bunch of water weight. You see, carbohydrates get turned into glycogen, which gets stored in your muscles with water. It's glycogen and water combining, going in your muscle, being ready to be used as energy, because carbohydrates are your body's preferred energy source for most activities. So when you start starving yourself of carbohydrates, your body doesn't have any glycogen, you're losing water. So when you see that 5 or 10 pounds in the first 2 weeks and you're thrilled with keto, just know that with any diet, you should only be able to lose about a pound or two of tissue, either body fat or muscle mass, which you wouldn't want to lose, but if your body is losing or gaining body tissue, it's usually at a rate of only about a pound or two a week. Anything more than that is water weight. And so you might still be happy. Well, it's fine, I'm down in weight, but that won't be sustainable. After that initial drop off of 5 or 10 pounds, now you've got to lose body fat, which is going to be much slower and harder. But also, the reason you lost that water is because you lost that glycogen in your muscles. So now, what's the problem with that? If you try to work out. For most people, trying to work out in a carb-depleted state is really, really tough. You're gonna feel weak, you're gonna feel tired, you might even feel sick. And so, for those people, if that's the issue, and their answer is stop going to the gym, that's a real problem. Because you wanna keep building or at least maintaining that muscle mass while you're dieting. If not, if you keep in a calorie deficit and don't do anything to offset the signals your body's getting, which is I'm starving, I need to give up some tissue somewhere, let's give up muscle mass because that actually burns calories, then you're going to lose your muscle that helps you stay strong, stay injury resilient, burn calories, muscle mass keeps your metabolism up, balance your hormones. So without that exercise, you're going to start losing all of that, and then you're going to run into a real issue. So you've got to find a way to maintain activity while you diet, or else it's not a good diet. Now again, there are exceptions. There are some people I know who have gone on keto and still been able to do their workouts, train jiu-jitsu, do many other activities, live a healthy life, a very active life, while being in ketogenesis. In ketosis. If that's the case for you, that's great. For the majority of people, it isn't. And that's why this diet came up big as Atkins and then dropped off. The majority of people could not sustain it. They couldn't sustain that way of eating, just all meat and fats and no carbohydrates, but they also couldn't sustain any activity. So if that's you, recognize that. Don't consider it a loss. I mean, it was a good trial. You learn that you can't stay on this long term. Hopefully, maybe you drop some weight in the short term that wasn't just water weight. But now transition to something that's more sustainable. Keep the healthy proteins and fats you put in your diet. Be happy that you cut out a bunch of garbage carbohydrates that probably made you feel like crap anyway and caused a lot of inflammation. And now put some more fruits and vegetables back in your diet. Don't worry about ketosis. Just start eating healthier but keep up that physical activity, your gym routine, your sports activity, whatever else you were doing, and just move on to a more sustainable maintenance phase of your diet. So again, overall, is keto bad? Not necessarily. It just doesn't work for the majority of people. They get really excited early on, then they start to struggle, and then they're really frustrated and confused. So if that's you, that's what's going on. You dumped some water, you lost your muscle energy, you're feeling tired, weak, maybe a little sick when you try to work out, and try to double down on the keto is not the answer. So shift into something more sustainable. I hope that helps. If you have any questions about it, send them my way. If you've got great success stories from keto, you've been able to do it for years, please tell me about it. And if you've also struggled and gotten off of it, but then found something else that worked, send me those stories as well. I'd love to hear it. I'd love to share those stories with others. I hope that helps. I'll see you guys.